Picture this. The year is 1975. It's a Monday, and you come back from your 9-to-5 job. On most other Mondays, you probably eat dinner, maybe watch the news, and then head to bed. But today is different. At the Bridgefield Coliseum, in Bridgefield Township, Summit Country, Ohio, they're hosting a boxing match between the Bayonne Bleeder, Chuck Wepner, and the reigning heavyweight champion of the world, Muhammad Ali. Everyone thought the fight would be over within the second or third round, but Wepner put up one hell of a fight. They went on for the full 15 rounds until Wepner was knocked out. Even though Wepner lost in the end, this was one boxing match that went down in history. Quick fact, this fight is pretty notable for being one out of four fights in which Ali was actually knocked down in the ring, but this was not the only thing this fight was notable for. Among the audience is a small-time actor who had only done a few small roles in some movies, but after watching the fight though, the actor was inspired and went into a writing frenzy. Within 3.5 days, a draft for a movie was written about a small-time boxer being given the chance to prove himself to the world when he is picked to face off against the reigning world heavyweight champion of the ring. Little did anyone know that this low-budget film about boxing would go on to become one of the greatest sports movies of all time. Hey there, my name's Colin Fish, and join me on today's cinema history as we take a look at the production of the 1976 classic, Rocky. First off, let's talk about development history. So, what happened after the script was written? Well, the script was shown off to United Artists and several other companies, and they saw potential. Actually, many studios wanted to pick up the script and make the movie, but there was one small issue. The studio wanted well-known actors at the time to take on the leading roles, such as Ryan O'Neal, James Caan, and Burt Reynolds. But, as it turns out, the writer of the script wanted to play the lead role. So, who is this writer, you may be asking? Well, you're looking at him. That's right, the movie was written by Sylvester Stallone. I recently watched Rocky with a friend of mine, and I was genuinely shocked to see that Stallone wrote the screenplay for the movie all on his own. Back to the story, because Stallone wanted to play the lead role, the script was rejected repeatedly until Winkler Schartoff Productions came in and picked it up, agreeing to the terms that Stallone would be the leading role. With a budget of $1,075,000 from United Artists, lead actor Sylvester Stallone, director John G. Alvedson, producers Irvin Winkler and Robert Chartoff, and the rest of the film crew set off to make the small boxing movie a reality. Before we jump straight into the production of Rocky, there is one small thing I want to talk about. Rocky was not the only character meant to be played by an entirely different actor. Originally, the character of Apollo Creed was meant to be played by real-life boxer Ken Norton, but eventually the boxer would drop the role, and the role of Apollo Creed went on to actor Carl Weathers. As for the lead female character, Adrian, she was originally meant to be played by actress Carrie Snodgrass, but due to money disputes, she turned down the role. Another actress who auditioned was Susan Sarandon, but she was also turned down from the role. Eventually, actress Tilla Shire landed the role of Adrian for the film. Production began on January 9, 1976. The film crew had just arrived in Philadelphia and began location scouting and shooting scenes. While this all sounds like the movie was off to a great start, this was still a low-budget boxing film, so the crew had to watch themselves on whatever they spent. But with every negative, there is a positive, and that positive was they got to play with a new toy. This new tool was a Spherical Steadicam, employed by Garrett Brown, who was credited for the special camera effects for Rocky. Using the Steadicam gave a photographer the advantage of using a handheld movie or a video camera and walk around at the same time. Thanks to the Steadicam, the crew was able to capture some footage for the fight scenes in the movie, and most importantly, the Steadicam was also able to capture smooth footage for Rocky's iconic Philadelphia street training scene and the scene where Rocky is running up the steps to the art museum. Another quick fact for those interested is that Rocky is the third film to use a Steadicam, the first being Bound for Glory and second being Marathon Man. Because of the film's smaller budget, the crew had to come up with some creative solutions to get around the production problems. An example of this is the scene at the skating rink. Originally, there were plans to have Rocky take the main leverage and agent to a busy skating rink, but to avoid having to hire extras, the team used creative change in context to fix the scene. Now, Rocky was taking Adrian to a closed skating rink. This use of creativity not only helped the scene fit within the budget, but also provided for one of the most memorable scenes in the movie. Other examples of this can be seen in the film, such as Stallone's family members playing minor roles in the film and the scene being written of Rocky pointing out his shorts being the wrong color on the banner in the arena, which was actually a mistake made by the props department. On Sunday, November 21st, 1976, Rocky was released in theaters. So, what did the critics and the general public think about the small boxing movie? Well, obviously, you all know the answer. It was a hit with audiences. The film grossed $5 million its opening weekend, and eventually the film reached $117 million at North American box offices. Because of the film's low budget of $1 million, it made it back over 11,000% of its worldwide percentage return. Rocky has also received positive reviews from well-known critics, such as Roger Ebert, who gave the movie 4 out of 4 stars. The success for his movie went as far as even being nominated for Best Picture at the 49th Academy Awards. The film won against big-name movies such as Taxi Driver and All the President's Men. And just like how it won the hearts of many Americans, it won the Oscar for Best Picture. It would be an understatement to say that Rocky just impacted cinemas. It left its mark in history, especially in Philadelphia. The training scene of Rocky running through the streets of Philadelphia and up the steps of the Philadelphia Museum of Art, accompanied by Gun of Flight by Billy Cotton, is one of the most iconic scenes in movie history. It is so iconic, there are shows and movies that parody the scene, such as The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air and the 2008 film You Don't Mess with the Zohan. There was even a statue of Rocky built in 1982 for the third movie in the series Rocky III, which is currently located in Philadelphia. Rocky is one of the greatest sports movies ever produced, and due to the success of the first film, 8 other films were produced. 6 of the films were sequels, being Rocky 2, 3, 4, and 5, and the 6th movie titled Rocky Balboa. The other 2 movies, titled Creed and Creed 2, serve as sequel series that follow the journey of the son of Apollo Creed, Adonis Johnson Creed. Rocky returns to fill in the older mentor role that used to belong to Rocky's own mentor and trainer, Mickey Goldmill. Along with the likes of Indiana Jones, Forrest Gump, and Luke Skywalker, Rocky Balboa has become one of cinema's most iconic characters, and I believe that's because we see a bit of ourselves in Rocky. It's because there are moments in our lives where we wish to be given a chance to prove ourselves to the world. It's because there are moments where we see ourselves as the underdog in our own lives. The story of Rocky Balboa, a small-time boxer from Philadelphia proving his worth to the world, will not only be regarded as a classic movie, but it is a tale that will go down in cinema history.